Hey guys, this is Vincent with VASCO Toys. On today's episode of Action VASCO, we're going to take a look at my most recent Alleyway diorama, which was inspired by this concept sketch. Let's take a closer look at the diorama. Here we have my Alleyway diorama. It's a four-piece diorama designed for an IKEA Detolf shelf. It has a base and it has three walls. This wall here, the back wall that has the door, and then this piece here, which is actually removable and is glued together, but is magnetized to the base and to the back wall. This diorama is the first that I've ever done 3D printed parts in as props. So the main pieces that are 3D printed are this fire hydrant, which is removable, not magnetized, this VASCO Toys sewer cap, which we're going to take a closer look at in a second, this electric utility box, the door handles here, and then there's a little VASCO Toys sign in the front that's 3D printed, and the final two pieces that are 3D printed are the window frames. So with that said, we're going to take a closer look at some of the different ACBA type poses that you can put into this diorama. So in this shot, I have the Daredevil set up fighting the two AIM soldiers. And the reason that I wanted to do this shot is so that you guys could see I did take off the wall that was here, because if you're using this for toy photography, especially ACBA type stuff, it's important to be able to remove these things so you can get different angles and get the shots that you're really looking for. So I'm pretty confident that this diorama has many different angles that you can get the types of toy photography shots that you really want to. Okay, so here we have the Daredevil. I wanted to give you guys an idea of some of the ACBA, articulated comic book art, type of toy photography shots that you can get in one of these dioramas. So I have the Daredevil here, and he's just finished off two of the AIM soldiers that were guarding this entrance in this alleyway. and I wanted to show you guys that these windows are backlit, so if you put a light source behind them, you'll get the effect that there's a light on in the building, which I think is a pretty cool feature. The last thing that I wanted to show you guys was the way the fire hydrant progression happens from the 3D print all the way to the paint. So this one here is the raw version of the fire hydrant with the supports removed. Normally when it prints, you have to include some supports to make sure that the different spouts that jet out here don't print incorrectly. So that's this one. Then I usually prime the fire hydrants with a black, and then I will hand paint the rest of this. So in this case, it's a red fire hydrant with some silver trim on it. And then I went in and added some rust, and I also added in some brown just to make it look like it's been dirtied up, because it is on the corner of a street. So that's the way it would realistically look. But I'm going to be doing a lot more 3D print props in my dioramas coming up, and I'm really excited to show you guys the types of things that I'm able to put into these. Thank you guys for watching this episode of Action VASCO, where we took a look at my alleyway diorama. If you like this video, please subscribe and don't forget to hit the bell notification so you get notified when we have our new videos come out. And also, please give us a follow on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, at vascotoys. If you have a commission request, vascotoys@gmail.com. Thanks, guys. See you next time.